Hey, and welcome again to Joystick Jockeys. As some of you might know, the Tokyo Game Show just happened in Japan a few weeks ago, and we're really excited because we get to show you guys some of the games that we've really been looking forward to. And I'm super excited because I get to show you guys a game that I've really been looking forward to, which is a PSP sequel to the Parasite Eve series, which came out way back in the day on the original PlayStation. And the game is titled The Third Birthday, and it's by SquareEnix.
Twelve years. That's enough time for a child to be born, to grow, and to start blogging about how they're too mature for Justin Bieber and Twilight. That is how long fans of Parasite Eve have been waiting for the return of Aya Breda. For those of you not yet acquainted, Aya is a cop from New York who gets special powers from her mutated mitochondria. She uses these powers to stop evil monsters from setting us all on fire. The biggest and baddest of these monsters being Parasite Eve herself.
It's been a while. I know I shouldn't have kept you waiting. But I'm here now.
This time around, the monsters are called the Twisted, and in typical monster fashion, have decided to attack New York. They have the ability to twist time and space and have set up shop in Lower Manhattan, right next to the Apple Store, and therefore must die. Aya's running with a new crew this time too, a government agency known as CTI, or Counter-Twisted Investigation. It's their job to stop the Twisted. But the only way to do that is through an experimental new system called Overdrive. And conveniently, Aya is the only person on the planet who can use it. The system works by separating Aya's consciousness from her body and letting her take over the consciousness of soldiers in the field. If she gets in serious danger in one body, she can instantly dive into someone else. This makes the gameplay very interesting, as you'll only have a certain number of soldiers on the field at any given time, and each of them has their own weapons and ammunition. If you need a hand grenade, you must dive into the soldier with the hand grenades. If you want to play sniper, dive into the soldier on top of a nearby building. Later on, you'll be able to dive into helicopter pilots for aerial attacks, or into tank operators to deal out some real firepower. Aya's parasite energy powers also make somewhat of a comeback with Liberation. Once you've taken enough damage, you can turn Aya into an enemy-evading, fireball-shooting crazy woman who glides around killing everything. As for story and characters, the game seems like a big departure, but if you look closely, you'll see more than just a few familiar faces from previous games. Yep, this game looks like it might actually deliver on all those big promises Square Enix keeps making. A deep story, an engaging combat system, and graphics so beautiful your PSP will probably blow up in your hand. Check it out for yourself when it comes out sometime in 2011.
The Third Birthday.
So, there's your extended look at The Third Birthday. If you're still hungry for more details, you can check out our Joystick Jockey Tumblr page. I put the link in the video description down below. So thanks for hanging out with us. And as always, you know, leave us a comment, give us a like, and don't forget to subscribe.